Hello students, myself Mr. Sandeep, welcome to my channel Maths Guru. In the last video we have discussed about exercise 1.2 of grade 10 for real numbers, that is chapter number 1. And now in this video we will discuss the problems given in exercise 1.3, the very important part of the question paper. These questions are very important from the examination point of view, so try to listen it very carefully. Okay, so first question is what? Root 5 is irrational number. Beta, already we have studied about root 5. Root 5 is what? 5 is a prime number. And then we have taken its square root. And when there is a square root of prime number, always this is irrational number. This we have studied in class 9th. But in this class, we will prove it theoretically. Right? So we will derive it that how root 5 is irrational number. This is very important question, beta. Have a look on its solution. See here. The question number 1 of exercise 1.3, prove that root 5 is an irrational number. So what we need to do here, we have to suppose that this is a rational number. ठीक है? हम उल्टा मान के चलेंगे इसको. Let us assume that root 5 is a rational number. Right? You know that rational numbers are what? Rational numbers are those numbers which can be expressed in P upon Q form. So if root 5, we are assuming this is a rational number, then it can be expressed in the form of A upon P. P upon Q ki jaga humne A upon B le liya hai. This is your choice. Okay. You can take P upon Q also. So if root 5 is a rational number, then it can be written in A upon B form, where A and B are co-prime integers. Very important reason, and this wording is very important. You have to understand the meaning of co-prime. Co-prime means which are the numbers which are not having any common factor. Clear? Again, I am repeating, co-prime numbers are those which are not having any common factor. For example, 2 and 3. For example, 3 and 5. For example, 5 and 11. So these are the pairs which are not having any common factor. So that's why they are co-prime integers. Okay. Then root 5 is equal to A upon B. And therefore, A will be equal to what? B will be crossing here. Root 5 into B. Clear? Then after that, stepping is there. Scaring both sides we get. So both hand side you have to square. A square is equal to root 5 square is 5. B square is B square. So we have got A square is equal to 5B square. What does it mean? It implies 5 divides A square. Okay. 5 divides A square. As you know, you can write down here. Maybe you in the junior classes you have written 8 is equal to 4 into 2. So what does it mean? 4 is dividing 8. So same we are writing here. 5 divides A square. Clear? This is the old knowledge. Now from this chapter, one theorem is there that if any number can divide the square of the another number, then this will divide the square root also. Okay, understood or not? So this is the theorem. If any number is dividing A square, then it must divide A also. So if 5 is dividing A, so see here again, if 4 is dividing 8, then 8 can be written as 4 into some number. Some number can be, it is some number is here 2. 4 2s are 8. So here 5 is dividing A, and A can be written as 5C, the multiple of 5. If 5 is dividing A, then A must be multiple of 5. So we have written A is equal to 5C. So put in the above equation. In the above equation, we have to put here this one, this row, this step. So A is equal to 5C will be put here. 5 square C square will give you 25C square is equal to 5B square. What it gives? 25C square will be cut here with 5. 5 5s are 25, C square is equal to B square. Now see, again you are getting this type of step, this one. 5C square is equal to B square. It means B square is being divided by 5. B 5 divides B square, right? It means if 5 can divide B square, then 5 must divide B also. That is the theorem. Okay. Now you can have a look on these two steps. This one and this one. 5 is dividing B. Here 5 is dividing A. It means 5 is a common factor of A and B. Okay, 5 is a common factor of A and B. We have proved here, but in the starting we have taken A and B are co-prime integers. Clear? So every step is having their own reason. Okay, so from equation number 1 and 2, it is clear that A and B have 5 as a common factor which contradicts. What do you mean by the word contradict? Contradict means oppose karna, virodh karna. Which contradicts our supposition? Wo hamari hi supposition ka virodh kar raha hai, jo humne mani thi, theek hai? That A and B are co-prime. Hence, our supposition is wrong. Therefore, after this one more line will come here. Therefore, root 5 is an irrational number. Theek hai beta? Hamari jo supposition thi wo wrong ho gayi. And what is our supposition? That root 5 is a rational number. Clear? So, agar rational nahi hai, toh what it will be? It will be an irrational number. Oh, I hope you have understood. So, have a look on the solution. You can take out the screenshot of this wording and try to learn it as it is. I have just taken the language from the very good book. Okay. Then come to, this is the first type. Root 5. Alone. Only single. Root 5. This is the first type. Okay. Then come to the second type of this exercise. Now we have to prove. Now, पहले आपके पास क्या था root 5 था अकेला. अब इसके साथ हमने क्या कर दिया 3 plus 2 root 5 डाल दिया. ठीक है. We have to prove that 3 plus 2 root 5 is an irrational number. So same way we will solve it. Let us suppose 3 plus 2 root 5 is a rational number. ठीक है. हम उसका उल्टा लेके चल रहे हैं. So this is rational. If this is rational, then it can be written in A upon B form, where A and B are co-prime integers. Very important to write down this reason. Marks are being deducted if you will not write down this language over here. Okay, I am telling you in the starting. So after that, 3 will be shifted on the other hand side. Plus 3 will become minus 3. Then here, A upon B is what? That is fraction. Wherever is the fraction, we have to take the LCM. So this B will be crossing here. 3B upon B after taking the LCM. After, in the next step, 2 will be shifted downwards. So A minus 3B upon 2B. What is A here? Integer. 3 is also the integer. B is also the integer. Integer minus integer will give you integer. 2 integer, B integer. Integer into integer, again integer. And integer upon integer will give you rational. Okay. So what it proves? Root 5 is equal to rational. Mean to say, whatever we have supposed, according to that supposition, root 5 is coming out to be rational now. But recently, we have proved root 5 is irrational. Right? It means we are just contradicting the fact. Kyunki isse pehle beta hum prove kar chuke hai na ki root 5 irrational hai. Agar prove ho chuka hai, then it means that is a fact. Wo fact ban gaya hai, wo ek sachai hai. So, but this contradict the fact that root 5 is an irrational number. This contradict the fact that root 5 is irrational number. Iska matlab kya hai? Hence, our supposition is wrong. This supposition is wrong. What is our supposition? That 3 plus 2 root 5 is a rational number. This is the supposition. So, that is wrong. So, therefore, it is an irrational number. Clear? Then, after this, the third type, the simplest one. Prove that 7 root 5 is an irrational number. Beta, these are the parts from your NCERT books only. You can see here. This is the question number 2. And question number 3, second part I have taken. This part is exactly similar to this part, second question. And this is similar to this. You can rationalize over here, or you can start like this only. And this is, both can be similar also. That is up to you. Okay, but try to solve it like this only. Okay, just shifting the terms on the both hand side. Now have a look on, prove that 7 root 5, right? First type is what? Alone root 5. Second type, plus mein kuch de diya. Third type, multiplication mein kuch de diya. Okay, so this is 7 root 5 is an irrational number we have to prove. Again, we will start with the same.
Let us suppose 7 root 5 is a rational number. If this is a rational number, this can be written in A upon B form, where A and B are co-prime integer. Important to write down. After that, 7 will be shifted here. Every time you can see, we are keeping here root 5 alone. Root 5 alone. So what you are getting here, integer upon integer. What is that? That is a rational number, which proves that root 5 is rational, which contradict the fact that root 5 is an irrational number. Hence, our supposition is wrong. So therefore, 7 root 5 is an irrational number. Clear? This is very simple part. Is it clear? So just have a look on this. You can take out the screenshot of this video so that you can have the wording of the solution for this question. I hope you have understood all the three types. One more type is there in which two square roots will be involved, like root 3 plus root 2, that we will solve later on while we are covering the extra questions. Okay, till then, thanks a lot for watching my videos. Like my video if you have understood properly, and subscribe to my channel. Thanks a lot.